Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the fish and game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
What the... it's... Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry, I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating. Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo? Oh, God. I don't know why I just called you that.
I found a walkie-talkie out here, too.
Okay.
It's going shithouse.
Well, get it if you haven't already, and then we'll figure out whose it is.
Will do.
Henry, are you there? What happened, Henry?
I got hit in the head, punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. You know, somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's where you saw that damn fence. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
Look, I know what I saw. Hey, it was our words with initials for our names, H and D, clear as day.
And you've been feeling okay?
I feel fine.
Okay, I'm sorry, I believe you, but that conversation was from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with a walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who. We should just get the hell out of here.
Oh, it's a 2-day hike. You're welcome to do it, but you're gonna catch hell from the service and have to explain yourself. Plus, there's a fire burning across Rose Creek. You hiked through there on the way in.
Call someone and tell them to come get me.
I am not going to book a $15,000 helicopter ride for you. I'm not doing it. Okay, we can't freak out. There's got to be a reasonable explanation for all of this.
You're right. I'll head to Wapiti Meadow, but I swear, if this gets worse, you better get on the horn and get us out of here.
I'll call around and see if anything weird is happening to anyone else, okay?
Sounds good.
Yeah, okay. Hike safe.
I'm hiking through the canyon. Which way is my best bet for getting to Wapiti Meadow?
It looks like you can find a trail on the north shore of Jonesy Lake, towards the west.
Thanks, Dee. Okay, I'm at the fence. I don't see anyone around, but I'm not sure I can get past it.
How big is it?
Big. It goes off in both directions. Acres.
But what the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it.
Sometimes biologists will cordon off a little area to study flora or whatever, but that's only a few square feet usually.
That's not what this is.
Well, see what you can do to get past it.
Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that. And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
Look, I'm not going to be able to get into this place.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
Thank you.
Hey, I called around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Should we call the cops or the Forest Service and let them know this is going on?
Don't you think that would sound, you know, crazy?
Yeah, it is crazy. We have to tell someone.
Tell them what, Henry? Tell them we're being stalked and you were attacked and we don't have any proof?
I don't know. Tell them we're being bothered or something.
Henry, I really like this job, okay? And if I give off even a hint of cuckoo to my bosses, they are never gonna let me come back out here. Do you understand that?
All right, I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay. Keep your radio close to you.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Hailing me, following me around, like working with other people?
Henry, you are way too much of a dope to be in the mob.
Someone is clearly able to hear us sometimes and was hiding near the lake. Come on.
Just
admit it. You're a little worried.
Of course I'm worried, but let's just try to keep things calm, okay? Keep things on an even keel. I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling. I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins. It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
He had his dad to protect him. Ned, right?
Yeah.
You don't think he could?
No, you're probably right.
It was 3 years ago. He's in high school now. He's on summer break.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Whoa, the flapjack fire isn't going anywhere, huh?
No, that's why those guys came out to burn that line. It's at the stage where all we can do is pay attention to it.
They're not gonna try to put it out?
Not yet, apparently.
Thank you.
I found where they did the controlled burn. I can hike right through here now.
Yeah, normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to Two Forks now that there's someone in it.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
Let's see. The scout camp is southeast of the river. There should be a pond on the way.
Got it. What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Ugh, are you serious?
Oh, come on. That one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay. That's how wound up all this shit has me.
There's some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
Whoa, someone stripped these snowmobiles down to the bone.
Huh.
I mean, that's weird, right?
I mean, I can come up with a bunch of not weird reasons someone would do that out here, but given what's happened, yeah. Yeah, that's weird.
There's an old pond out here, not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah, I know where you are.
Yeah? Where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, folks kept stealing it.
Because it's called Pork Pond?
It's a good goddamn name. That sign would look great in a den, or, you know, anywhere.
So, is the scout camp anywhere near Pork Pond?
Yeah, it is. Just keep heading east. You'll cross a small ravine, and you shouldn't be able to miss it. You're there?
Yeah, I am.
It's been out there since the 50s.
I was never really into the idea of the scouts. It's something about men organizing boys around their ideals. Never sat right with me.
Beware weebelows in large numbers.
Beware of anyone in large numbers. The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Good plan.
You ever talk to any of the scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say to preteens.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, If forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
What type of nerdy hobbies are we talking about with him? Like, marching band?
Oh, no. Like, comics, model rockets, wizards and wyverns, you know.
Ugh.
Hey, thanks to Brian, I can almost recall by memory the armor classes of most dragons.
The what? No, you can't.
Hey, planar dragon's armor class. Let's see.
Okay, no, I believe you. We're good. I guess these little shelters are where they keep the Weeblos.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
There are bear traps out here, in the scout shelters.
Scouts are stalwart prey.
That's messed up. Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up.
Damn.
I found an axe.
If one of the crew left it, that thing is actually called a Pulaski.
It looks like an axe to me. This thing will be a huge help.
For both getting through the backcountry and getting through that fence.
Hey, Dee, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss.
Did it say anything of note?
Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would need someone to give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
Us. They're researching us.
You think they're studying you and me?
I do, yeah. I mean, maybe it's about studying two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else, what they do?
Yeah, that's what I think.
Well, fuck that.
Agreed.
I think we should allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but... God, if you saw what you said you did... Fuck, Henry.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
Well, I've got an axe, so I can figure out a way to get over the ravine and back towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you. you there? I had a thought.
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh, fuck. There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
Thoroughfare Tower, this is Two Forks calling you for the, 50th time today. The Flapjack fire continues to move in a southerly fashion. Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
You can do me for a trip out of here. I don't care if it's on horseback or a helicopter or in a canoe. Just get me out of here.
Henry, we have work left to do. Let's chat about what's bothering you and you'll feel better.
Are you serious?
Let's talk. Okay?
Okay.
By the way, I was wondering if your Flora of the Shoshone info poster was still up inside your tower?
What?
It's just protocol that those stay up. You know, info about your tower, the surrounding tree species, etc.
All right.
Just, you know, have a look at it. Make sure it's in ship shape.
Okay, yeah, it's up. Why are you acting like this?
Great. Just wonderful. Do you see the tree in the top row, second from the left?
Let me look at it, and I'll tell you.
No. You don't need to tell me, just, internalize it. It's a great tree. And there's an area called, that tree's name in your sector that maybe you should take a midday hike to. Maybe.
Which tree am I supposed to internalize again?
Top row, second from the left. Head to a place named after that tree, and you'll have a wonderful afternoon.
I'm here at Cottonwood Creek.
You see the cash box there?
It must be around here somewhere.
It is. Find it and open it. I changed the code. It's 5678.
Are you kidding me?
I was in a rush.
Okay, found the cash box.
Great, open it.
I found what you left me.
Good. Call me back with when you have it.
I've got it now.
Good. I spent all day getting you that radio. I hiked to a cash box, lied to a ranger, lied to another ranger, and hopefully you are now holding a clean, untapped radio.
Hopefully.
Holy fuck, Henry. We have to get into that site.
What the fuck is going on? People are listening to us?
I don't know.
Our radios are tapped? Are you fucking serious?
Our radios are definitely tapped. That's why I left you the one you just got.
How is this even possible?
I don't know, Henry.
What do you know?
I know that I'm scared. None of it makes any sense.
Are there any other lookouts this is happening to? Someone else in on this? Anyone?
This is just happening to us. Everyone else is fine.
Are you sure?
Yes. I've tried to bring it up to Chimney Rock, Elk's Fork, and Beartooth Lookout, and every one of them got confused. Asked me if I'm okay and if I need to be relieved. Our fucking state coordinator asked if I was just having lady troubles. So no, this isn't happening to anyone else, and I'm done asking.
Who is doing this?
I don't know who could be doing this. Henry, I've been at this job off and on for 13 years. Sometimes here, sometimes over near Jackson, a couple times down in Wind River. And nothing like this has ever happened before.
Am I just making all of this up? I mean, the eavesdropping, the spying, is this... Fuck, is any of this real?
What? Are you serious?
Maybe I'm just losing my mind.
What?
Like Julia. Maybe it's happening to me, and I'm imagining that I have a boss out here and that we're being spied on.
Henry.
Maybe there was something in the water, or our condo was underneath some power lines, and you, Delilah, you're not real.
Henry, think about her. If what happened to her were happening to you, you wouldn't even be able to realize it.
Okay.
Henry, sweetie, I am real and this is happening. I'm as real as the sky is blue. Take a second and then call me back. I'm on your side.
Okay, I'm all right. I'm headed towards the site.
Good. Keep your head up. Hey, I just thought of something not great.
What is it?
I filed a report that said that neither of us ever talked to or saw those girls, the ones that went missing a few weeks back.
Oh, shit.
My thoughts exactly.
Our radios were tapped, and now someone probably has a transcript of that entire conversation.
And I've filed a report that's a blatant lie.
Oh, and those girls are still missing.
Yep.
Fuck, Delilah.
Fuck indeed. We really need to get to the bottom of this.
I just heard something.
What is it?
I don't know. It was goddamn terrifying, though.
Well, it could be an elk, or it could be someone trying to get you to radio about a loud noise so they know where you are.
Fuck.
How about you don't do that again?